Go.
Okay, to get the cable off, just turn that up and you can pull the cable off. And then lay the cable down, plug in. You should always work from your power point and make your turns away from the cable. Don't turn into the cable. Turn away from the cable. Now it comes, this red light up here will tell you that power's to the machine. So you know that there's power there, that the cable's plugged in. You undo the lever by just lifting it up and closing the clamp. You don't turn this. Just like that. That's it. That'll give you what you require for that adjustment. If you need to adjust it, because once when it's new, you need to, it breaks in a little bit, you just tighten that nut at the back. And that nut is a 13 millimeter spanner. Just give it half a turn or so and that should be enough. In order to get the pad on and off, you tilt the machine on its handle, and then the pad nut is undone. There's a little arrow here to say off in that direction. You can just go like that, and then this nut comes off, and then you just pull that off. When you're putting the pad on, I'll put the clean side on. Make sure it's centered properly, otherwise you could get vibration through the machine. So try to make sure that that's centered properly over that. And then when you put that on, you can just hold on to the turn the pad as well and just turn that till it's... Try to do it so it's pressed in, otherwise this could scratch the floor if you don't do it tight enough. When you pull up the lever, get it to a height so it's sort of sitting. Don't have it too high, it's too hard to control. Try to get it down so you're comfortable. Your arms are sort of basically relaxed. Not too much, not up like that, so your elbow just comfortable. Push that on and you're ready to go. To operate the machine, there's a couple of things. It's a switching up here, but also to adjust the pad pressure. The pad is adjusted when the machine is new, but the only time you need to adjust the pad pressure is depending on the floor surface, and also when the pad starts to wear and flattens down, you may need to put a bit more pad pressure. And certainly when you put a new pad on, you've got to go off the pad pressure. To adjust the pad pressure, you only need to turn it half a turn at a time. You don't go crazy turning it. And if you got it turned down too much one way, you know something's not right. You don't need to. On this machine, you can tell if you got too much pad pressure because the machine will pull too much to the left, to the right. So to operate, these are the locking buttons to control. You can't turn the machine on without pushing the buttons. Now you only need to operate one, or you can operate both. If you're left-handed, you might be more comfortable with the left. Vice versa. This switch here on the left-hand side is the vacuum switch. Now remember, it's critical that you don't use a machine like this over a wet surface. If you do, you're going to suck up water. If you suck up water, that's water and moisture can go right through the electrics into the vacuum and into the capacitors and damage the machine. If you have an overload situation where you're using an extension lead that's not correct or something like that is happening or the machine's too overloaded, it's possible that this little red button here, which is a reset button, could pop. So always check that. Look at what you're doing first. Why is it pulling too much amperage? Check that just what's going on, that the pad pressure is correct. You don't have an extension lead. Because when you use an extension lead, you're getting a voltage drop. And when you get voltage drops, amperage goes up. So as voltage goes down, amperage goes up. This can only operate on a 10 amp circuit. It'll be comfortably running at the moment for around 7.5, 8 amps. But if you change that too much, you could go over the 10 amps, and that may occur. Okay, so to run it, we push that down, and the machine starts. And that's about the rest of that. And that's how the machine operates. Now, once you're finished operating, you know, lift the handle up. You can turn that down, and you can roll up the cable. As you're rolling up the cable, always check that there's no nicks in the cable. Now this cable is a rubber cable, so it's very flexible compared to a PVC, but always as you're rolling it up, use your hands and eyes to just check that there's no damage to the cable. If there's any damage to the cable, you should report it right away and have the cable replaced. That up, and don't roll it up too tight. You don't need to put a lot of pressure on it, just roll it up so that it's comfortable. Now come around here. If you need to get the lid off and check that the vacuum, you just give that a twist and that releases. So that's a bayonet fitting that just twists and comes out, and you get the lid off and you can empty the filter bag. Make sure the bag is sitting properly when you put it back, and the lid goes over the recess in the canister here and just quickly clicks into place.